I also wanted to give some. I was thinking about The Last of Us 2 like all night.
Yeah.
And I just wanted to give like some more final thoughts, but now I fucking forgot all of them.
Why? How?
What?
You thought all night and you
I thought all
anything?
Night and now we've been.
What were you thinking about?
It's just like.
What do you
want to
say about it?
So it's still a very divisive game. A lot of people hate it.
Really?
To this day. Yeah. Everyone. There's like a solid. I mean, it feels like there's so much more people, but I feel like it's probably only like a third of the fans of the first game, like vehemently hate it, but they hate it so much that that's just all you're seeing is people hating on the game. But I feel like a lot of people out there do enjoy it. And it's one of those things where you're witnessing this game as you're playing it, just play out in front of you. And for me, I feel like I was watching the next classic, like the next masterpiece in storytelling in general is The Last of Us Part 2. Because like you look back to like a fucking Kubrick, David Lynch, fucking all these different kinds of storytellers that have gotten flack for what they made in like their time. I mean, look, even Citizen Kane, people hated that movie when it came out, but now it's like regarded as one of the timeless classics ever.
Never seen it.
I mean, it's old, really old.
Yeah.
And it's one of those things where, of course, people are going to hate it.
Yeah.
Of course, people are like, because the main character in the first game, you're playing as him for so long. It's like 6 or 7 years before the second one comes out. You're just playing as this character and like loving him and you're all for him. You're like, man, they're going to make the next like Nathan Drake from Uncharted. They're just going to keep using him for like all the next games because he's so bankable.
And then they Game of Thrones style.
Yeah, they just
cut Ned's head off.
Pretty much. Like you're just seeing this his like bludgeoned bloody face like fill up your screen. And it enrages you. You're like, I fucking love that character. Why would you kill him off like that?
Right.
And that's like the best way to just send you fucking screaming to try and get the killer. But then when they flip-flop it, it's like, no, they've lived that same story. This is just their perspective. This is how the girl that killed Joel felt when her dad died.
Yeah.
And it's they draw all these parallels and even some parallels to the first game. And it's just, I mean, I was like, of course this guy's gonna get a bunch of flack for doing something that's
different.
No one would dare do.
Right.
Unless you had the means.
Or like actually tell a good story.
Yeah. I mean, video games. I mean, you can say this about any form of storytelling, but video games create such a unique and. Oh, God, what's the word? Immersive form of storytelling.
Right.
Because you're literally playing at the story as you want.
Yeah.
So, and to see that these characters are doing things that you don't want them to do, but you're forced to do it. This is how the video game wants it to go. You're going to have to do it. Cause at the end of the game, it's like, you have to stab they're trying to make you stab the villain at the very end. You have to like tap X. And I was like, I don't want to, I don't want to do that. That's I love both of these characters now.
Right.
No matter what. And that's something I've never felt before in a video game.
Right. Right.
It's incredible. And it's definitely going to go down as one of the greatest video games of all time.
Yeah, because it sounds like, I mean, it's kind of like that Sopranos thing. They, like, make you fall in love with Tony Soprano, even though he's, like, a fucking monster.
Or Breaking Bad.
Yeah. Well, Walt just turned into a fucking psycho.
Well, yeah. And that's kind of what you see in Last of Us. You're like, man, this character's awesome. I'm rooting for him. Like, I'm rooting for the story.
Yeah.
And then he makes a choice that goes against what the plot wants to do. The plot wants to save humanity. Joel doesn't want to save humanity. He wants to save Ellie. So he saves her instead of humanity.
Which is a bitch move.
Which, I mean,
bitch move.
It all comes down to like the grief you feel from losing a loved one. Because Joel lost his daughter at the beginning of the first game. And then he comes across this young girl that he has to protect. Doesn't want to at first. He's like, I'm not dealing with this shit. And then he goes to love her. And at the very end, he doesn't want to do it. He was carried out to do the whole time. He can't do it. He has to save her.
Fuck. What an idiot.
Yeah.
What an idiot.
And even in that, it created a very controversial discussion.
Right.
Even in the first game.
telling you, I'm hacking that little kid up myself. Just saying. You ain't getting no second game.
I'm sure you would.
You ain't got to worry sure about a would. Second game.
It's just that's how they wrote the character.
Sorry, I care about humanity. Fuck, wear your mask for Christ's sake.
Hey, it's only a video game. That's why they can get away with telling these kind of stories.
That's true.
But yeah, I just wanted to give some final thoughts on it.
It sounds great.
It's so good.
Yeah, it sounds phenomenal. Yeah. I love that.
I'm going to play it again for eternity.
You know, there's nuance and there's like actual human emotion involved.
Yeah.
And there's, you know, like that weird, it's just controversial like to
you're like they're
have
like
to
completely
make choices like that and then like to see both sides of the story and yeah. like that's you don't see that in video games.
It's almost completely breaking the rules
right.
of video games.
Right.
It's like, why would you play as the villain?
Right.
You're fucking stupid. No one's going to like that.
That's fucking dope.
But they did it.
I think, yeah. And like, there's all these, everyone's always trying to like push, you know, graphics and gameplay and all of these, you know, little things there where like at the heart of it, you would almost think like, well, how have we been telling the same stories over and over again? Why isn't anyone pushing that aspect of it?
Yeah.
But that's the whole part. Like, I remember when I first played Final Fantasy VII.
Oh, yeah.
And Aeris died. Spoiler alert.
I haven't played it, but yeah.
But yeah, it was like, I was in like sixth grade or fifth, you know, I was young. This is on PlayStation, you know, and I was just like, oh my God. Like, I felt emotional about it.
Yeah.
I was like, this is fucking dope. You know, like, storytelling is at the heart of the whole thing.
And at the end of the day, that's what the writers hope to accomplish. Mm-hmm. It's mm-hmm. for you to care about a character.
Get some emotion involved.
And when they get cut the fuck out, right. you're like, what the hell?
Right.
I liked that made up person.
Mm-hmm.
Why'd they have to die?
Right. Because we're so desensitized to, like, at first, like, the only emotion you needed to feel was, like, you just needed to be wowed,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Yeah.
Like, you just needed to be like, whoa, that's fucking crazy. Oh, this is fun. Or like, you know, like you would play a Madden or something like that, you know, very, very basic, you know, lizard brain yeah. shit. But like what actually gets people into all this shit is like having like an emotional connection with the characters.
Yeah.
Or, you know, like wanting to see them succeed. You know, if you're telling those stories, obviously sports games will never go away. It's just mindless fun.